our first speaker time, Governor Ashbaugh. Carolyn is one of our new members. She's done a great job so far. So please help me welcome Carolyn Box.
Mr. President, good evening, Toastmasters, distinguished Toastmaster Nick Smith, and most welcome guests. My name is Carolina, and in 1986, I was 5 years old. I'll make it easy on you today, that makes me 42 years old. But back to 1986, my parents, the 20-something-year-old rebels, could not stand living under the communist regime in Poland. They had enough. They had spent the last few years sneaking through borders to sell goods in accompanying countries and bring goods back to Poland to sell. They did this with the intent that one day the opportunity would come up that they would have enough money to make their escape and get out of Dodge. In the fall of 1986, that opportunity surfaced. Italy. We are going to Italy. We're going there for Christmas, and we're going there on a 4-day pilgrimage. The Pope is Polish. We are devoted Catholics, and we want to perform this act of devotion. We really need to go on this 4-day pilgrimage, is what my mom is telling the man at the passport office window while she is handing him our paperwork for passports. My dad, at this time, he is 50 miles away that way in another city, saying the exact same thing to a man in a window at the passport office. See, if we showed up at the same passport office as a family, chances are my parents, my mom and dad, would get their passports, and I would not. At this time, in a communist country, what they did is the children never really got passports. And the reason why that happened is to ensure that their parents would return and continue to enjoy all the luxuries and benefits of communism.
Right.
Well, success. We got our passports. Quietly, my parents packed their belongings. They shared their plans with just their parents and two best friends. One friend drove us to Warsaw to get to the airport and get on that plane, and the other friend packed up the rest of our stuff and sold it for us. And off we went. On the 4th day of our pilgrimage tour, the tour guide, a gentleman visiting his kids, and the communist spy that was there to accompany this tour, got on a bus and to head back to the airport. 26 people on that tour, plus the three of us, went across the street and we went to the train station. We now had 26 new friends. 2 hours later, our train stopped in Latina, Italy. We arrived at a refugee camp called Campo Profughi Latina, and the whole tour group walked in. They slapped their passports on the counter one by one. We are officially refugees. At this moment in my life, a new direction was taken. This was the first 180. For the next 2 years and 2 months, we were refugees. Out of the 26 rebel friends we made, a portion are good friends still till this day, and some of them we call family. After 3 months in Latina, we moved to an apartment in Caselli. We moved there to make space for the next round of refugees coming. 5 months after that, we moved to Rome. Our new home was on Via Aurelia, and the building was known as Sporting. This building was a hotel that was built for a sort of world athletic games in the 80s. Us and about 200 other refugees are now residing here for the next year and a half. And what an amazing year and a half it was. As the saying goes, when in Rome, we did just that. My parents worked, I went to school that was taught by nuns, and we had some amazing family trips. We climbed Mount Vesuvius all the way to the edge to see the crater, and then the city of Pompeii nestled below. We toured Rome and the Vatican in extent, including the catacombs under the St. Peter's Basilica. A private tour of the Monte Cassino grounds where the Battle of Rome took place by a veteran who lived to tell the tale. Countless occasions to meet Pope John Paul II, and so much more. At this time, I was 5, 6, and 7 years old, and some of these trips were absolutely boring. But they are some of the clearest memories I have till this day, and I would cherish every opportunity I had as a refugee, and I'm so glad my parents did this. On February 28, 1989, 34 years ago to the day, was my next 180. We are now off to Canada. We arrive in Canada, in Edmonton, Alberta, Canada, and I see snow for the very first time. It was fluffy, it was sparkly, it was absolutely magical. But that is a story for another time. The 180s in my life continued. With all the 180s that have been presented to me in my life, one thing is clear. It appears that I am right exactly where I need to be, right in line of my path, right in the middle here. Thank you so much. Yeah.